نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is the fourth lecture from the series Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in light of the Quran and the Sunnah. And if you recall, the first and second lecture we spoke about the definition of aqeedah, the significance and the importance of the aqeedah, and we talked about the sources of our aqeedah being the Quran and the Sunnah and the Ijma'. Those are the fundamental sources, and then comes in the reasoning, and the fitrah are secondary sources for our aqeedah. And then we spoke about the people who went astray once it came to the issues of aqeedah, ta'rif al-iman, the definition of al-iman, and the people who say that if you commit a major sin, you're a kafir, and you're going to stay in the hellfire for eternity. And we spoke about also the people who do not accept the ahadith al-ahad in the issue of al-aqidah. And we kind of gave an introduction. Then we spoke in the third lecture about the evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists. And we mentioned five evidences. Number one is al-fitrah. Number two is intellect, al-aql. Number three, the divine revelation. Number four, al-du'a, the fact that you make du'a and someone answers you. Number five, mu'jizatul anbiya wal rusul, the miracles which the prophets and the messengers were given as a way of proving that they are conveying this message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, if you believe that Allah exists, then you must do something called tawheed. What is tawheed? I'm going to go slow, take my time, and if you don't understand, I will repeat. First of all, I want you to dismiss anything that you have already regarding this subject from your mind and just clean it and just take this for now. And you will see that it will match, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, what you have, if what you have is correct, insha'Allah, and you'll enjoy it. You always hear the word tawheed, 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 tawheed. What is tawheed? This is an Arabic word. An Arabic word. What do you mean by tawheed? Literally, tawheed means وحد الشيء أو أفرد الشيء. Making something one. And one, I would like to use the word uniquely one. Meaning it is not made of components. Because there is something that is one but can be made of components. The Christians, they tell you that we believe in the oneness of Allah. But that oneness is made of what? Three. Father, Son, and La, uniquely one, that means it is not made out of components. Wahada, afrada, wa minhu qawlullahi ta'ala, dharni wa man khalaqtu wahida. The baby in the womb of who? The mother. Wahid comes down what? Wahid. Making something one, asserting the oneness of something. Again, we're explaining the word tawheed, where it comes from. Tawheed is to make someone, something one. And again, I want to stress, uniquely one, meaning it's not made of what? Of pieces. Like the car is one, right? But it's made of what? wheels, engine, doors. No, Allah is uniquely one. He is not made of what? Of components, of things put together. طيب. The technical definition of Tawheed. Are you ready? So we define Tawheed in the language. The word Tawheed in Arabic, what does it mean? What is the technical definition of Tawheed? Singling out Allah. Singling out here means Ifradullah. Tawheedullah. Making Allah one. Each one of you must memorize that definition. At-Tawheed. At-Tawheed is to single out Allah. Single out is the meaning of what? Making something what? Single. Huh? Single. Singling out, that means to make something what? One. Singling out Allah in His that essence. No one is like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it comes to His essence. That. Allah has a that. Allah has an essence, right? But is His essence, His that, like the creation's essence? So you're singling out Allah in His essence, in His that. None is like Allah once it comes to His that. This is one. Once it comes to His actions, af'al. For the Arab speaking, I'm going to give it to you. Ifradullahi bidatihi wa af'alihi wa asma'ihi wa sifatihi wa huquqihi. Ifradullah. في ذاته أو بذاته وأفعاله وأسمائه وصفاته وحقوقه. Singling out Allah in His essence. Actions. Actions refer to الربوبية. الأفعال. أفعال الرب. Meaning you single out Allah to be the creator of everything. If you believe that Mother Nature created, have you singled out Allah in His action? Have you? So you must believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who creates. الله خالق كل شيء. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the creator of every single thing. So you single out Allah to be the creator. طيب, did He create and neglect His creation? Well, first of all, did He create and leave others to own His creation? No, He still owns it. تبارك الذي بيده الملك. He owns everything. الملك التام. You may own, but you're gonna leave, you're gonna die. And leave it, and at the end it's gonna go to who? Let's say to your children, and your children are gonna inherit it. But when the day of resurrection is here, Allah even call upon the people between the two blows in the trumpets, and He say, "لمن الملك اليوم." أنا أتكلم عن الملك التام. ملكك أنت ناقص. Your ownership of what you have is short, because you will leave it, or it can be, you will leave it by what? You die, don't you? Or it can be taken away from you. A rich guy go into the internet, check the stock market, the halal one hopefully gone. أنا أتكلم عن ملكك. ملك الله ملك تام. So singling out, Allah once it comes to his essence, actions, أفعال. We're talking about four main أفعال here. Four main actions. Memorize those. الخلق والملك والتدبير. And there is a fourth one. Huh? والرزق. الخلق والملك والتدبير. So you single out Allah to be the creator. That is why a Muslim cannot believe that the nature created or the evolution or الملك Allah what owns it. Imagine and وهذا من رحمة الله. There are things in this universe that Allah never leaves ownership to anybody else. يعني I want you to imagine someone owns the oxygen. The oxygen. What is he going to do to you? طب imagine somebody owns the sun, the moon. Close the oxygen in order for you to live. يعني من رحمة الله سبحانه وتعالى. Yes, he left some people to own certain things. But once it comes to the main things which we need, no. الشمس مثلا. Can you imagine somebody owning the sun? Okay guys, the sun is not going to come out tomorrow. And you haven't paid the taxes yet. Where is the fees? The heating bill? Huh? Where? Huh? The light? القمر. فالملك والتدبير. الملك والتدبير. And the fourth one, لأن الرزق comes under التدبير. الرزق comes under التدبير. So creation, sovereignty and control. اللي هو التدبير. يعني التدبير that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends guidance which can take care of you. I don't want to overwhelm you. Let's go back to the definition. Again, we're trying to define what Tawheed is. Singling out Allah in His essence, actions. Actions, the word actions refers to rububiyyah. And if you don't know what rububiyyah means, forget it. I will explain it to you in a minute. But just say, Tawheed is to single out Allah in His essence and actions. Good? Is the definition complete? What happens to the names and the attributes? His names and attributes. Then His rights upon us. What is the right of Allah upon us? Ya Mu'ad, أتدري ما حق الله على العباد وما حق العباد على الله؟ What? أن نعبده ولا نشرك به شيئا. That you worship Allah and never associate someone and worship with Him. هذا هو التوحيد. Singling out Allah. إفراد الله بذاته وأفعاله وأسمائه وصفاته وحقوقه. حقوقه here refers to what? الألوهية. إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله. So you single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in His essence, actions, names, attributes and His rights. هذا هو التوحيد. We got that? We got that? If you didn't understand it, just hang in there. We will re-explain this again, but in a different way. Just hang in there. طيب. Categories of Tawheed. First of all, we must say that none of the companions nor our righteous predecessors actually, in the sense of the first three generations, divided Tawheed into categories. Like I'm saying right now. But this is a technical way of conveying the message. There is nothing wrong with it. As long as, because the people of Bid'ah, they say, look at you. You guys are inventing. You guys are dividing Tawheed into Rububiyya, Uluhiyya, Asma'u, Sifat. Where do you get this from? The Prophet ﷺ never taught his companions Tawheed this way, this manner. Ya Sidi, we tell you it's a technical way of teaching. We provide evidence for this. It is just an easier way to get people to understand what Tawheed is. As simple as that. And once we talk about Tawheed, anything that we say, we have supporting evidence for it from the Quran and the Sunnah. There are some people who divided Tawheed into only two categories, two types. And there are some who divided it into three. But let's deal with the two. Those who divided Tawheed into two categories, into two types, they said the first type is Al-Ma'rifah wal-Ithbat. Tawheed al-Ma'rifah wal-Ithbat. Yani, knowing who Allah is. Obviously, you need to know who Allah is before you worship Allah. And once you learn who Allah is, then you come up with the second type of Tawheed, which is what? Al-Qasd wa-Talab. That you say, I'm going to worship this Ilah. So the first thing that you learn who Allah is, He's the Creator. He's the one who created you. He owns you. هو السيد المطاع. He's the sustainer. He's the one who gives life. The one who gives death, causes death. The one who guides. The one who causes misguidance. If the person has already an intention to be misguided. The one who benefits. The one who harms. النافع الضار المحيي المميت, the one who provides. He has beautiful names and attributes. Now, you learn who Allah is, then you come up with the second type, which is what? توحيد القصد والطلب. That you say, I'm going to worship this Ilah. I'm going to worship Allah. The first type includes the Rububiyya wal Asma' wa Sifat together. Because the Rububiyya has to do with the names and the attributes. Sifatul Rabb. And the Asma' wa Sifat. Now, once you establish that knowledge, then you go ahead and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But inshallah, in the lectures which we will deliver here, we're going to go with the second categorization, which is Tawheed al-Rububiyya, singling out Allah to be the Rabb, then singling out Allah once it comes to His names and attributes, and then singling out Allah in your action to Allah. So, Tawheed al-Rububiyya, Tawheed al-Asma' wa-Sifat, and the third type is called what? توحيد الألوهية. Allah being the Ilah. So what is the first type of Tawheed? الربوبية. الرب. الرب means what? He's the creator, the owner, the sustainer, the provider, the one who gives you. When you need Him, He provides for you. Ibrahim alayhi salam says, Illa Rabb al-Alameen, Alladhi khalaqani fahuwa yahdeen. The one who created me and the one who guides me. Walladhi huwa yut'imuni wa yasqeen. And the one who gives me food and gives me water. Wa idha maridtu fahuwa yashfeen. And if I get sick, He cures me. Walladhi yumeetuni thumma yuhyeen. And the one who gives me life and death, and He will resurrect me again. والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين. And the one who owns the day of resurrection. كل هذه ربوبية ده الرب. ما هو شوف يا إخوة, we go back to سورة الفاتحة. Look, الحمد لله رب العالمين, ربوبية. الرحمن الرحيم, أسماء وصفات, names and attributes. مالك يوم الدين, the owner of the day of resurrection. Man, if he is all of this, then you should say what? You should say what? What is the next verse? إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Have you ever understood الفاتحة this way? الفاتحة is about التوحيد, about those three kinds. See, Allah is the رب. الحمد لله رب العالمين. You're the رب who created me. وأنت رحمن رحيم. You're merciful, you provide. الرحمن الرحيم. And not only this, there is a day of resurrection. مالك يوم الدين. If you're smart, then you should say what? You should say what? إياك نعبد. I will worship you. I will single you out in my action. I will achieve the second, the third type of tawheed, which is tawheed al-uluhiyya. And for your information, yani I want to say, I'm going to jump the gun, but I'll go back to this again. You see, the third type is the most important type. No one denied the first and second. They messed up with it. They called the Lat wal Uzza. They did some ilhad in the names and the attributes, but they never denied it. But really, the most important type of tawheed is the third type. اللي هو توحيد الايه؟ اللي هم للكفار أجعل الآلهة إلها واحدة. اللي هو لا إله إلا الله. That they single out Allah in their action. That they worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى. حتى الشيطان يا إخوة, even شيطان, he never denied the ربوبية. الشيطان never denied, Satan never denied that Allah is the رب. Huh? When Allah commanded him to bow down to Adam and he refused, what did he say? Huh? Allah asked him, why didn't you bow down? قال لم أكن لأسجد لبشر خلقته. هو الخلق هذا من صفات الربوبية ولا لا؟ Isn't creation from the attributes of ربوبية or not? وخلقتني, and you created me. The حتى when even when he wanted to live longer, قال ربي what? أنظرني, make me what? كل هذا ربوبية. All of this is what? ربوبية. But where did شيطان fail? In what area did he fail? في الأمر اللي هي الألوهية. And this is what a lot of Muslims are feeling at. A lot of Muslims, by the way, they think لا إله إلا الله means لا خالق إلا الله, لا رب إلا الله, لا مدبر إلا الله. لا 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 لا, لا, لا. هذا كله ربوبية. ده حتى الكفار, even the كفار, they never rejected this. ولئن سألتهم من خلق السماوات والأرض ليقولن. If you ask عتبة وشيبة والوليد who created the heavens and the earth, they will say who? ولئن سألتهم من خلقهم, who created you, they will say what? Allah. But where did they fail at? In what area? The third time. طب صلي لله, يقول لك لا معلش ما بقى. طب زكاة, لا 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 ماليش. طب انت تؤمن بالله؟ نعم. لا خالق الا الله, لا رازق الا الله, لا بارئ, نعم. بس هذا ربوبية. اسمع هذه, listen to this. توحيد الربوبية لا يدخل احدا في دين الاسلام. توحيد الربوبية, انت عارف الناس دول يا اخوة, those people, the Muslims, انت بس تعذرهم بالجهل, لكن if you look at the reality, the people who do not pray, لا يحققون, they do not achieve لا إله إلا الله, they do not, because what is meant by لا إله إلا الله, that you worship Allah. لا, Muslims now they think what? All what you have to believe that the creator is Allah, the sustainer is Allah, the provider is Allah, the one who cures is Allah, the one who benefits is Allah, the one who harms is Allah. طيب يا سيدي, worship Allah then. They say no to it. طيب فإن شاء الله we will follow the second type of categorization, which is what توحيد الربوبية توحيد الأسماء والصفات وهذا إيه التوحيد العلمي الخبري علم that you know who Allah is, you know his ربوبية, you know his names and attributes, and then comes in the second type which is what القصد والطلب اللي هو الألوهية. They call it توحيد الألوهية, they call it توحيد العبادة, they call it لا إله إلا الله. أهو. Are we good so far? We're doing good? Huh? Simple stuff. طيب. Let's go into توحيد الربوبية. And by the way, this is just an introduction. Even if you don't understand it this time, we're going to have a whole lecture about توحيد الربوبية. And what does it mean that you believe that Allah is the Rabb? Yeah? Meaning Allah is the one who creates. Meaning Allah is the one who provides. Meaning Allah is the one who owns. Meaning Allah is the one who controls. And so forth. Allah is the one who benefits. Allah is the one who harms. Okay. If I ask you, define Tawheed al-Rububiyya. I want to ask you, define Tawheed al-Rububiyya for me. What would you say? Come on. تفضل. إفراد الله بالخلق والملك والتدبير. التدبير بيشمل كله. التدبير بيشمل الرزق والإحياء والإماتة والنفع والضر والهدى والضلال والإيه والرسالات كله. ما هو الإيه؟ ما هو الرزق هذا مش الأكل والشرب فقط. الرزق is provision is not only eating and drinking. الهداية رزق. Being guided is a provision. فتوحيد الربوبية is to single توحيد الربوبية. The definition of توحيد الربوبية بالعربي, in عربي يا إخوة, إفراد الله بالخلق والملك والتدبير. Those three. Mistakenly I said four. لعلي قرأت هذا خطأ يعني. Here it is. توحيد الربوبية in English now is singling out Allah the exalted with the actions of creation. Sovereignty, something like that. الملك, sovereign, sovereignty. الملك, dominion. He owns. And then, التدبير. يعني التدبير, disposing the affairs of his creation. You single out Allah. Here it is, a good breakdown for this. It's singling out Allah, the exalted, with the actions of creation, providing sustenance, giving life, causing death, and all the types of regulation, administration of the dominion of the heavens and the earth. Singling out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the exalted, with the right to judgment and legislation and sending of messengers and revealing books. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. Did we get this? You single out Allah, الربوبية, single out Allah to be the what? The Rabb. And if you didn't get it, don't worry. We're going to have a whole lecture. The next lecture actually is going to be about Tawheed al-Rububiyya if we manage to finish this tonight. طيب. توحيد الأسماء والصفات. This is a cornerstone here. توحيد الأسماء, الله المستعان. توحيد الأسماء والصفات. You single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى regarding His divine names and attributes. ما هو Allah has names and attributes, correct? How many names does Allah have? How many? 99? Huh? How many? Indefinite. A lot of people mistakenly they think that Allah only has 99 names. لا يا حبيب. اللهم إني أسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك. Oh Allah, I ask you, in all the names, in any name that you named yourself with, revealed it to one of your messengers or any of your books, or you kept it to yourself. And we know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the day of resurrection, when the people ask him to intercede for Allah to begin judgment, he will go and prostrate in front of the throne, and he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ثم يفتح الله علي بمحامد لم يفتح بها على أحد من قبلي. Allah will teach me names and attributes that no one else knew about it. فإياك. طبعا الناس يظنون ان هذا الحديث صحيح. لله 99 اسماء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names. 100 except one. طيب من احصاها دخل الجنة. الحديث صحيح. Whoever does احصاء. احصاء is not memorize. احصاء is to memorize, to learn their meanings, implement it in your life, and call upon Allah with these names. Now people think, especially with these people who put the 99 names in, at the end of the Quran, they think Allah only has 99 names. La, there are 99 names of the names of Allah. Of the names of Allah. First of all, you always hear me saying name and attribute, right? Didn't I say names and attributes, names and attributes, names and attributes, names and attributes, right? But I want to ask you, what is the difference between the name and the attribute? Come on. Huh? Say? Attribute describes the description of the name. طيب, if I say Al-Ghafoor, what does it mean, Al-Ghafoor? The forgiver, right? The one who forgives, right? Is that a name or an attribute? What?
It's an attribute.
What do you mean? The one who forgives. Is that a name or an attribute? That's a name. طب, what is the attribute? What is the attribute? Forgiveness, Al-Maghfira. Is the attribute. طيب, Ar-Rahman, is that a name or an attribute?
Name.
What is the attribute? Ar-Rahma, mercy. طيب, can you derive a name from the attribute? You see, that's the greatest difference between the two. Can you derive a name from an attribute? طيب, I want to tell you something. وَمَكَرُوا وَمَكَرَ اللَّهِ. They blotted and Allah blots. What is al-makr here? Blotting is what? Is that a name or an attribute?
Attribute.
Can you derive a name from that attribute? Can you name Allah to be al-makr, the one who blots? No. So you can derive an attribute, two or three. You could actually do more than one attribute from the same name. Al-Maghfira, you could say Tawwab. Ghafoor, you could say Tawwab. Al-Maghfira, you could say Al-Af. Attribute of Al-Af. Attribute of Tawbah. So you could derive from the name more than one attribute, but you cannot derive from the attribute one single name. You see the difference between the two? Did you get this? Huh? Assalamu alaikum. Did you get it? Inshallah it will come. Yani, hang in there. But see, here it is. With regard to the oneness of the divine names and attributes, means what? We affirm the names and the attributes of Allah. If Allah said that Ana as-Sami', I am as-Sami', I am the hearer. So we must believe that Allah what? Hears. And we also must affirm the attribute, the description. We must believe that Allah has a hearing. Lillahi sama. We must affirm that Allah has a hearing. We must affirm the attribute. The people who went astray, they say Allah hears without a hearing. Allah, He sees without a vision, without eyes. Allah doesn't have a hand, those guys, they ended up what? Making Allah to be what? Attributeless, no attributes. So singling out Allah in His names, we must believe in the names and the attributes which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named and described Himself with. Where? In the tongue of who? Where? في القرآن. What is the, we go back to what is the source of our aqeedah? Quran and what? Sunnah. Whatever is mentioned in the Quran, Allah told me in the Quran that أنا عفو أنا غفور أنا رحيم, I must believe that. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah is this and this في authentic sunnah, as long as it is there. And I must also affirm the description that comes. Because people, there are people who went astray in this field, ya ikhwa. They negated the description. They say, Allah, yes, Allah hears, but without a hearing. Allah sees without vision. La. We believe that Allah sees with a seeing, with eyes. But now, are His eyes like our eyes? لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. You know, there is another way to go about this. Is His essence like your essence? مَا هُوَ ذَاتُ is the essence. Is your essence like my... Okay. I hear and Allah said that I am the hearer. Correct? Yes? طيب. Is my essence, يعني essence, that يعني, like Allah's essence? My essence, I cannot live without. My essence, I have to do what? My essence, I have to go to the bathroom. Does Allah need this? So why do you want to make His sifa like my sifa? Why? ده حتى يا إخوة في أشياء عجيبة. رب العالمين يقول لك في الجنة في موز وفي تفاح. In the paradise, there is banana, there is apples, there are birds. We'll eat. طيب ابن عباس يقول إيه؟ The only mutual thing between what we have in Jannah and what we see in this world is what? Names. Just the names. But they are totally what? Different. Oh. فتوحيد الأسماء والصفات يا إخوة, this is a key to love Allah. A key to increase your iman. But if you have to get it right, if you get off in one single thing, dangerous, very dangerous. That's why you have to be very careful. And inshallah, after Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, we're going to talk about Tawheed al-Asma' wa-Sifat in details. But quickly, and if you don't understand this again, please don't give up. We're going to talk about it in details. Tawheed al-Asma' wa-Sifat is based on two principles. Two principles. What? Pay attention to this. This is a very interesting piece here. Tawheed, singling out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it comes to His names and attributes, is based in two principles. Two principles. Ithbat wa nafi. Affirming, denial. طيب الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Where is the affirming in this and where is the denial? Allah, there is no one worthy of worship but He. He's the ever-living. هذه ربوبية. شايف ربوبية. ليه? Why? He's ever-living. قيوم. He التدبير. قائم. He provides. He takes care of you. And then هذا الإثبات. إذا نثبت. We believe. We affirm that Allah is الحي. The ever-living. القيوم. The sustainer. But then comes in what? The denial. We deny what? لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. He does not sleep. ما هو, when you say الحي, ما هو, aren't you حي? Aren't you حي? أنت حي ولا لا?
Yes.
You're alive or not?
Yes.
But don't you need to sleep to carry on living?
Yes.
Don't you? But with Allah, we deny what? He doesn't sleep. Not even a slumber of a sleep. A slumber of a sleep. القصة هذه الإسرائيلية أن موسى عليه السلام asked Allah, how come you do not sleep? قال يا موسى, stand up and hold an object in his hand. He stood up for a day. He got tired. The object fell down. والله يا موسى وعزتي وجلالي, by my majesty, by my power, if a slumber of a sleep would take me, the heavens will crumble in earth. ورد هذا في القرآن سورة الحج, ويمسك السماء أن تقع على الأرض إلا بإذنه, and he holds the heaven from falling down in earth. When this will happen? When Israfil blows in the trumpet, بإذنه, when he gives the permission to Israfil to finish the dunya, to destroy this world. So we affirm the names and the attributes, and we deny whatever he denied. Oh, here it is. ليس كمثله شيء. Is that denial or affirming?
Denial.
Denial. None is like Allah. Nothing is like Allah. Nothing is like Allah. وهو السميع البصير. Is that denial or affirming? إثبات. وتوكل على الحي الذي لا لا يموت. Rely on the one, the ever living. الحي also حي, because حي could mean, because a person is alive, that means he could what? ممكن انه ايه؟ لا هو لا يموت. He doesn't what? He doesn't die. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما سمع أصحابه ينادون يا رب ويرفعون أصواته بالدعاء يا رب يا رب يا رب, حديث في صحيح البخاري, حديث أبي موسى I believe, ماذا قال له؟ He said what to them, اربعوا على أنفسكم, take it easy, فإنكم لا تدعون أصما ولا غائبا. You're not calling upon a God who is deaf. So Allah is not what? Deaf. He's not absent either. When Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا إخوة, لما ذكر لنا الدجال, ذكر لنا الدجال, الدجال is going to come and say, I'm your Lord. وإنه إيه؟ الدجال is what? The Antichrist is what? A blind eye. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ, and your Lord is what? Is not our. فإيه؟ نُثْبِتِ الصِّفَةِ وَنَنْفِي الإيه؟ ما ورد فيه النفي. We deny and we affirm. We deny, we affirm. We deny, we affirm. But here is a very important piece. We affirm without trying to make the name or the sifa, the attribute of Allah, resemble. يعني الناس احتاروا. People got so weird in the issue Allah استوى على العرش. Allah rose above the throne. طب يعني استوى? What is the meaning of استوى? على واستقر. هذا هو المعروف عند العربي. He rose and he sat on the throne. طيب في ناس يقول لك طب ازاي استوى? How? Should you ask how? Should you? Should you try to visualize it? No. Should you say that, well, he rose in the throne like somebody else rose in the throne? تشبه? Now some people said, you know what? I don't think this ever happened. It means istawla. He came up, negated the whole thing because he doesn't get it. Imam Malik, ya ikhwa, summed it up in one sentence. You can carry this to the rest of the names and the attributes of Allah. When the man entered into, when he was delivering a lecture, And he asked him, what is istawa ala al-arsh? What is the meaning of istawa ala al-arsh? Al-istiwa'u ma'loom. والكيف مجهول والإيمان به واجب والسؤال عنه بدع. Rising above the throne is knowing. How? Do we have to believe in it? Should we try to know how or ask how? This is a bid'ah. يا أخي رب العالمين لما يتعبدك بهذه Allah did not ask you to visualize it. Why do you do it? Why do you do it? ما هو Allah did not, you see Allah did not, Allah just ask us believe in the صفة, believe in the attribute, the way the words means without resembling it to the human attributes nor seeking to find out how. As simple as that. Inshallah, if you did not get this, brothers, just wait. Let me read to you what I have here. If I ask you to divine the names and the attributes, Tawheed al-Asma' wa-Sifat, describing Allah, the Most High, with the names and the attributes He described Himself with in the Quran, or the Messenger described Him in the authentic Hadith, and we affirm what Allah has affirmed and His Messenger without resemblance to the creation. We shouldn't say that Allah hears like us, Allah sees like us, هذا resemblance, هذا تشبيه, or negation, تعطيل. You say, well, Allah hears without what? A hearing. تكييف, you try to make it what? Like this. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Are we good?
Yes.
Is it fun or what? This is fun, I'm telling you. طيب, the last ayah, توحيد الايه? الألوهية. Now you learn that Allah is the creator, the sustainer, the owner, the provider. And He has all these beautiful names and attributes. If you're smart, you should come up with the third type, which is what? وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا. الألوهية. إيه هي الألوهية يا إخوة؟ Do, no choice. سمعنا وأطعنا. We hear and we obey. And this is what لا إله إلا الله, like I said at the very beginning of the lecture, this is what لا إله إلا الله is. A lot of Muslims, they think that لا إله إلا الله, that, oh, لا خالق إلا الله, لا رازق إلا الله, لا, يا حبيبي هذه ربوبية, ما أحد أنكر هذا. لا إله إلا الله, that you say to the creator, the sustainer, the provider, يا رب, whatever you command me to do, I will do. إنما كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا. We hear and we obey. هذه الألوهية. إن شاء الله يعني needless to say that الألوهية يا إخوة is where a lot of people are astray. Where a lot of people are astray. And this is what is meant by لا إله إلا الله. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the books. طيب, here is a very important piece, and pay attention to this. I think you already got this from, I kept stressing it. Do you think there is a relationship between the three types of tawheed? There is a relationship, no? They are somehow related, correct? تلازم وتضمن وشمول. What do you mean? Look at this now. The relationship between the three types of tawheed, necessity, inclusion, and comprehension. احنا, this is very academic, يعني this is academy. The شغل, يعني this is colleges, class, okay? It's not, open up a little bit. يعني تلازم. يقول لك, توحيد الربوبية necessitate, is that a good word? Necessitate توحيد الألوهية. يعني إيه؟ If you believe that Allah is the creator, Allah is the provider, Allah is the sustainer, Allah is the one who benefits, Allah is the one who causes harm, Allah is the one who guides, Allah is the one who gives life, Allah is the one who takes it away, Allah is the one who created you, then it is necessary that you do what? To worship. وده يقول لك ايه؟ توحيد الربوبية necessitate. I'm always myself, necessitate, is that right? Necessitates توحيد الألوهية. وده يقول لك ايه؟ شوف أول آية في القرآن يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم. أول آية يعني in that context يعني يا أيها الناس oh mankind اعبدوا الألوهية اعبد worship. Why يا رب؟ Why؟ What is the criteria يا رب؟ Why؟ الذي what؟ خلقكم. خلقكم. ما هو الخلق هذا ربوبية ولا ألوهية؟ ربوبية. يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم. Not only you. والذين من قبلكم. ده انت تيجي تقول لك ايه؟ قل الحمد لله وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. listen هذا. الله خير اما يشركون. is Allah better or that which they worship in association with him؟ هياتي بصفات الايه؟ الربوبيه. امن خلق السماوات والارض. the one who created the heavens and the earth. وأنزل لكم من السماء ماء فأخرجنا به فأنبتنا به حدائق ذات بهجة and brought down water gardens came out. ما كان لكم أن تنبتوا شجرها. look أإله مع الله. should you worship someone beside this؟ الإله اللي خلق ونزل المية. the one who created brought down the water got you go and worship some. والله هذا يعني من لؤم البشر. لؤم البشر. the ungratefulness of the human beings. أمن جعل الأرض قرارا وجعل خلالها أنهارا. كل هذه ربوبية. وجعل لها رواسي وجعل بين البحرين حاجزا. أهي الألوهية. أإله مع الله. الربوبية إيه؟ necessitates what؟ أنت تعبد الله. بقى يا أخي رب العالمين He created you giving you by Allah. how much did you pay for the life that you have? How much? Where were you before this life? ده شوف ده في آية في سورة البقرة يعني معجب. كيف تكفرون بالله. you tell me how you make sense of this. how dare you disbelieve in Allah. وكنتم أمواتا فأحياكم. when you're nobody where were you before this life. هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا. You had no existence. He given you the life that you have. How can you disbelieve in Allah when you were nothing? And He gave you the life. Nothing. You were nothing. And He given you the life that you have. Not only this. ثم يميتكم. And He will make you die again. That's it. ثم يحييكم. And He will bring you back to life. كل هذه ربوبية. The relationship between الألوهية and الربوبية what? الربوبية necessitates what? That you worship. Allah being the Rabb must drive you to who? To الإله. طيب. What do you mean by توحيد الألوهية includes توحيد الربوبية? It's really a representation of what I just said. If you worship Allah alone, that means you believe is Allah is the one, the only one who what? who benefits and the only one who gives life, يعني includes. It's included. If you only, because if you believe that there is someone else who harms, someone else who benefits, you're going to still what, go out and call upon that other God. But the fact that you're singling out Allah in your action, إذا سألت فاسأل الله, if you ask, ask Allah. وإذا استعنت فاستعن, why the people who go to the fortune tellers? Why the people who go and put these things in their hands and these things they hang things in their necks? Shirk, why? Because he believes that there is another force out there that does what? That benefit and harm. Lakin al-muwahhid, the one who believes that Allah is the one who benefits, Allah is the one who causes harm, will only worship who? Allah. And he knows Allah is the one who does this. No partners. Al-asma wa sifat, comprehension. What do you mean? Some of the names of Allah are rububiyya. Some of the names of Allah are what? Uluhiyya. So al-asma wa sifat eh? Includes both. So this is the relationship between the two. Alright? If you did not understand this, by the way, we're going to go one by one. Inshallah. The next lecture, if we get to finish this, if you help me to finish this today. The first lecture, we're going to talk about Tawheed al-Rububiyya. Then we're going to take a while, Tawheed al-Asma wa al-Sifat, because we're going to throw the principles, and then we're going to go into Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, اللي هي لا إله إلا الله. طيب, deviant sects within Muslims, once it comes to Tawheed, top of the line, الصوفية. إيه الصوفية عم الحج؟ إيه الصوفية دول؟ الصوفية, they believe in something called وحدة الوجود. They deny, negate, they do not believe in the name of Allah, that Allah is above what? The throne. طب where is Allah يا عم الحج؟ في كل مكان. الصوفية يا إخوة يقولون لي إيه؟ اسمع هذا. الحق هو عين الخلق. Allah is in every place. You look in it, Allah is here. Allah is here. Allah is here. Wherever you go. وضل يعني أنيل من نصارى worse than the Christians. حتى النصارى النصراني يقول لك الله بس في الايه, في الصن والهولي جوست بس. النصراني يعني his عقيدة is better than the عقيدة of this person, because the Christian believes that Allah came down in the form of who? Of who? عيسى أو الهولي جوست. مين؟ لكن دول ايه, they believe that Allah is everywhere. وحدة الوجود. That is why when they sit in their things, huh, and they do their dancing, Allah will be like, Hadrah, Hadrah, يعني Allah what came what? Hadar fi, يعني. La mushkila. يعني people think that this stuff is easy, يا إخوة. يا أخي, أنت بتسأل الله, where is Allah? What is important about this? Where is it? يا عمي, ما هو, this is the problem. If you tell me Allah is everywhere, that means Allah can be, هو, the Christian, I'm sorry, the disbelievers of the Arabs. What did they used to say about their idols? ما نعبدهم إلا. They say we don't worship the idol. No, you don't get it. We don't worship the idol. We worship the spirit that resides inside what? They don't deny that. ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفى. لا, أهل السنة يقول إيه, الله على عرشه. لذا يفتح باب إيه طويل. Open a door for. يعني just to let you know, one of them is, his name is, I came across this statement. He says what? عبد الكريم الجيلي, one of their scholars. He says what? أضل الناس المحمديون. شايف الكلمة؟ The most deviated people are المحمديين. يقصد أهل السنة. The people. شوف. وأهدى منهم الثانوية. And better guided or more guided those who believe in the existence of two gods. ما هو في الثانوية. في ناس يقول لك إيه, في إلهين. إله الخير, the good, and what? الليل. The day and the light and the night. They believe that there are two gods. some of them said evil and good. Some of them say what? The night and the day, light. وأهدى منهم الثانوي وأهدى منهم المثلثون. And more guided than them, those who believe that Allah is what? اللي هم إيه؟ Christians. وأهدى منهم الذين يرون الله في كل شيء. شايف الكلام؟ كفر يا إخوة، كفر. And more guided than them, then are those who see Allah in everything. يعني أنظر هنا، الله يزير. والعياذ بالله. هذه الصوفية الاتحادية يا إخوة، بتوع وحدة الوجود، ابن عربي والناس دول يقول لك الرب رب والعبد عبد، إن قلت رب فأين المكلف، فذاك رب فأين العبد. العبد ذي الرب، العبد ذي الرب، الله is here inside me. طب if you say Allah commands، طب who commanded who؟ ما هو. طب those went astray in what area؟ In what area؟ In what type of توحيد؟ ها؟ أسماء الصفات، names and attributes. إحنا أهل السنة نثبت صفة الإيه، we believe صفة الإيه، العلو. أأمنتم من؟ يا جارية أين الله؟ ها؟ Oh young girl, where is Allah؟ في السماء. اطلقها فإنها مؤمنة بنصوص اهو. فدول نفوا دي نجدت صفة الايه؟ العلو. شوف صفة واحدة، one صفة، one description that Allah did not rise above the throne. This led to what? On the throne, on above the throne in the seventh heaven. But he is with us with his knowledge. Recognition. He knows what's going on. You got it? How? Should we ask? Should we visualize? That's beautiful. That's the way it is. بس with you. هو السميع. He is the all hearer. You hear too, don't you? But look at this now. You hear now and hear. Do you hear the people in the parking lot? Do you hear the people downtown Denver? Do you hear the people in China right now? Do you hear the people in Tahrir Square in Cairo? Do you hear them? Guess what? Allah hears everybody at the same time. Sami'a. وبعدين في قصة، قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها وتشتكي إلى الله والله يسمع تحاوركما. A woman خولة بنت ثعلب. She came complaining about a companion. He took my wealth and so. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when the woman came complaining about her husband, he took her to the side. Fa'aisha is on the other side of her room. We know the room of Aisha is not what, that what. But she did not hear the whole thing. She heard what? Bits and pieces. So she's complaining about her husband. She's complaining about her husband. And then as soon as she left, Jibreel comes down. قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها. Allah has heard the whole thing. You know what she said, Aisha? سبحان من وسع سمعه الأصوات. Blessed, glorified, exalted, that the one who is hearing encompasses what? ها أنا ذا. Here I am in the same room next to them and I didn't hear what she said. وهو على عرشه. And he's above his throne and he heard it. هذا هو. ما هو ايه؟ ما هو المشكلة؟ ما هو واحد يقول لي ما الله في كل مكان، ده مشكلة. الله في كل مكان؟ الله في كل مكان؟ لا. ده انت تفتح، you open a door for what? Misguidance. يعني يبدو أن الوقت لن يسعفنا. It looks like the time is not going to help us. فإن شاء الله we'll begin the next lecture talking about الأشاعرة الجهمية القدرية الجبرية الروافض. All of these are sects. All of these sects, these sects went astray in this field. And you know what field? You know what field? الأسماء والصفات. الأسماء والصفات. The names and the attributes. They twisted. That is why it's so important to learn about it. Inshallah, we will begin next lecture talking about the deviant sects within Muslims. People who say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. And again, I want to stress the fact that don't think that we're talking about groups here. People are grouping somewhere and say that we are al-Jahmiyya, we are al-Asha'ira. No, you actually could hold, you, I'm talking to you, and I talk to myself too, to be fair. I could hold some of the misunderstanding of those people. You could belong to those groups, to these sects, deviant sects, without knowing. If you ask an average Muslim now, someone who doesn't have the knowledge, where is Allah, ya akhi? You will like Allah is everywhere. Ya am, everywhere, eh, bas, ya am, al-hajj, everywhere, the mushkila. Everywhere. Then Nasara, you will like Allah is in three, bas. In tagulli, everywhere. That you're worse than the Christians. Inshallah, we'll begin, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, the next lecture talking about the deviant sects within the Muslim world. Once it comes to the three types of tawheed, tawheed al-rububiyyah, توحيد الأسماء والصفات وتوحيد الألوهية. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك، والحمد لله رب العالمين.